Instead of a ball of lava. Men who have taken British place now taking Britain for a laughing stock. I'm a British taxpayer. I personally fought the Queen's Army for 6 years of a young life. My taxes pay the wages of Sinn Féin representatives and in turn for the nice comfortable lifestyles of the League.
We could be the fucking bring the fucking balaclavas on day.
Then you have mothers, fathers, brothers and sisters who have lost family in the hands of these elected men who are having to pay their wages if an outrage and a point overlooked by the government. Now tell me, if I committed murder or any one of you that are standing here before me, acts of terrorism and treason to my country, would I be allowed to stand as a public written representative?
No, no, no.
Would I be allowed to earn £30,000 to £50,000?
No, no, no.
Would I be allowed to live my life of own infringement?
No,
no, not a chance. Westminster are more than happy to bend at the knee in order to keep the Republicans in this country at bay. But my question to them is, at the cost of the welfare of the British loyal taxpayer?
Not on.
Being a serving soldier in the British Army, I was sent to different corners of the world to hunt down terrorist leaders and fight back the terrorist cells within that chosen country we were sent to. Britain fight against terrorists and have taken British leaders out of power with the likes of Colonel Gaddafi, Saddam Hussein and Osama bin Laden.
Hey.
Now correct me if I am wrong. Are the IRA not a terrorist organisation?
Yeah!
What about the war in Jena?
Apart from the Guinness, Terry Adams and Terry Kelly, not all terrorists, are still born Where is your stand when it comes to them? Where is your justice to the families hurt by these terrorist leaders? Where is your justice to those families who have to live in Northern Ireland under the free reign of Sinn Féin IRA? Since the removal of the Union flag from Belfast City Hall, there's been over 200 arrests to date, mainly for peaceful protests. Regimental boys stand with those of People's Forum, and we will call for the immediate release also of all loyalist prisoners locked up for public order offences. Why should it be a crime to fly Her Majesty's flag on Her Majesty's streets and on Her Majesty's buildings? Why is it the PSNI arrest these men and women for this? Why is it the PSNI whose job is to uphold British law are not doing so? Why is it the British courts and British judges who swear an oath to uphold justice in the name of Her Majesty's British law still send loyal British men and women to prison for simply being loyal? This is the point where I say we will be calling for the Human Rights Commission to get involved. If these prisoners are not released by Sunday the 14th of April, that is a week from today.
Yeah.
We stand in the BBC studios and we with them, obviously it's fallen on deaf ears.
Usual.
We are standing here outside the BBC studios and we were wanting to plead with them on behalf of our brothers and sisters locked up away from their wives, children and families for being only loyal. We were wanting to ask them for their help in the name of justice. The doors have been locked. It seems that...
I'm not interested, there's a media blackout.
You are such men if you listen to.
The British Broadcasting Company.
Anti-British Company.
There is people inside that building that can hear my voice. The British Broadcasting Company, we urge you to please take your letter we will provide you with after a speech and help us loyal British citizens peacefully right all wrongs. We call for Westminster to get involved and sort out our own country first before helping others, as we stand here as British taxpayers and ask for your help, as we do need it. We stand here now with nowhere left to turn. So to clarify what Regimental Blues asked from Westminster, we demand the immediate release of all loyalist prisoners subject to flag issues and protesting issues without conditions of bail being set upon them. We call for the bail conditions set upon Mr. William Fraser, Jamie Bryson and Mr. 10,000 to be lifted with immediate effect so they may stand for their people and community to change things the political way like they've always done. We call for an open and public investigation into all Northern Irish policies from the property if they have been left to run free with British movements, sorry, British tax money, and do as they please. They have also controlled the police force and their party within the British political system, and they have, sorry, apologies. They have also controlled the police force and their movements since the flag was taken down. Also, we want Sinn Féin firmly told that they are a political party within the British political system and they must behave accordingly. The Union Flag was took down single-handedly from Belfast, which is a capital city within Britain, should immediately be raised 365 days like before.